Radiological findings in Huntington's disease. So the most striking and best known feature is caudate nucleus atrophy that could be appreciated in the MRI. So we can see there is bilateral caudate nucleus atrophy. And on morphometry, we can see there is prominent putamineal volume loss, and that is not well elaborated on visual inspection, but it is well seen in morphometry, and it is particular in case of younger patients. So in this red color, there is, we can see there is prominent putamineal volume loss. So this, in this red color morphometry, we can see over there. And these both things, that is the caudate nucleus atrophy and the putamineal volume loss, leads to enlargement of the frontal horns, and that gives them a box like configuration. So we can see it is basically more or less like a box configurations. And these all findings could be summarized into measurement. So we can see the frontal horn width, that is the frontal horn width to the intercaudate distance. So there is an intercaudate distance. This ratio is decreased in Huntington's disease. Similarly, the intercaudate distance to inner table distance is increased in Huntington's disease. That is, we can see FH by CC is decreased. Similarly, CC by IT is increased. So this is a high yield point for USMLE neurology. Thank you.